Hey everyone, welcome back to Sky Adventures, episode number 2. Picking up actually probably at least 3 days after I originally left off. Here in the little hole we made last episode, I moved everything down here just because while mining it was easier to just walk over here and repair my pickaxe and then go back to mining because the durability is ...65, so it breaks really easily, so it just got a little annoying. Also, I went ahead and killed a few sheep to make a bed so I can set my spawn point there. Also did a ton of mining, not really a ton, but you know, as you can see, I got a few stuff sorted real quick. Got some copper, got some iron, got some tin. I'm gonna pick up all the marble I can, as that is gonna be the material we use to build our central hub or whatever you want to call it. A bunch of other materials in here as well. But today we're actually gonna continue. Oh, I think I put that away. In our quest book, if we look in our quest book, what am I looking for? Tools and weapons, getting resources for smeltery. So we need to collect 60 sand, gravel, and clay, and craft 120 grout, which will be used to create our smeltery, which we're actually gonna do this episode. Actually, you know what, just hold on a minute. Sometimes if I restart my game, the lag will go away, so... I don't know why it does that. I'm gonna guess it like refreshes something. I have no idea. I'll just get rid of the lag real quick. Alright, we're back. Also, as you can see, I've begun construction of my house. Not the central hub, just my sleeping quarters. Oops. Sleeping quarters, which I will continue to which I will continue to work on off camera after this episode. I'm just gonna place a few torches down real quick. Also chopped down a bunch of trees and placed a few torches around the area to prevent mobs from spawning. Looks like we have some time to go out and get some sand. Clay. I already got the gravel and sand from just mining around here. And actually what we're gonna do before we go out, we're gonna take our bed, repair this real quick, and we're actually gonna take our crafting, our tool station, just in case we have to repair our shovel while in the middle of getting clay. That way we can just easily do so. Unless you can... No, I didn't think so. So, we're going to take our tool station and our bed just in case we have to sleep. So, if we open up our journey map, I haven't really done a lot of exploring. I know there's like an ocean over here and an ocean over there, but so we're going to go over here. I think that's the world spawn area. Also gonna kill any animals if we see them, because I believe we still have that quest to do as well. Click here to show. Click here. Okay, getting started. Open. So we did the 3 sheep. We need to kill 3 more cows and 10 pigs. Thought I killed a pig already, but I guess not. So if we find any of them, we'll just slaughter them real quick. Pick up berries while I'm at it too. Oh, another thing real quick. hats. It's a mod. I ended up picking up this pig hat, and this tree hat, and this wood hat. It's just something to... Oops, wrong button. Oh, it doesn't actually show you on the... That's weird. Oh, maybe I didn't equip it. Okay. Haha. See, there's a pig on my head now. Huh. A pretty cool mod if I do say so myself, but I'm sure... What the fuck? Poison. How the fuck did I get poisoned? What the fuck? How the fuck? Oh, poison ivy, okay. Yeah, be careful of that. Oh, poor pig. Whatever you were. Also, a cool mod that's on here is called Vein Miner. Allows you to hit the little squiggly line next to the number 1 and easily pick up an entire vein of stuff. Just makes mining a lot easier and makes chopping down really big trees a lot easier as well. Let's see if there's any clay in this area. I know clay is mainly popular in swamp biomes. I think it's the swamp biome. Unfortunately, I don't see a swamp biome anywhere. Oh yeah, I also did die 2 times off camera. I don't want to talk about it, so just a bad time. Alright. I really don't like to go deep in the ocean looking for clay. Kill these 3 cows that I need to kill for the reward. There you go, where's one? Really need to make a sword. 2. What the fuck? What the fuck are you? A spirit? Okay. Well, as long as you don't hurt me, then... Oh my god. Come here. Oh, not seeing any clay. Quickly plop down our bed and go to sleep so the mobs don't spawn and kill us. And pick up our bed. Gotta get 60 clay, I believe it is, for the smeltery. Also forgot to set my timer. As usual, nothing new. Just trying to find the clay on these little outer edges. Or if I could find a swamp. That is a cool freaking hat. I want it. Awesome, mushroom hat. You just get the hats by killing any animal or mob that is wearing the hat you want. So, there's 3 out of 10 pigs, need 7 more pigs. And we're gonna hit H for our hat. And we're gonna put on the mushroom hat. Awesome. Oh, hey, got a hat too? Blue screen of death hat, awesome. Alright. Alright, see, oh, it's clay right here. So if you just hit the little squiggly line next to the one, it'll mine all that up for us. And we got the clay we need, okay. Actually gonna collect a little bit more than I need for the quest, just to have it. Alright, awesome, now we can head back home and begin crafting us up a nice smeltery. See if there's any more pigs. I don't see any more pigs on my mini map, so eat the sheep real quick. Right. I see sheep over there. I killed all the sheep I need. Just walk to my death points. And try to avoid poison ivy, apparently. I do want to pick up this marble, but I want to know what this is. Quarried stone. Don't think I want you. Right, almost there. Such a far walk. Alright, here we are. Jump over that. And also, if anyone's wondering about the snow, I fought a blizz, which is like the ice version of the blaze, so they kind of left snow everywhere. Is that poison? Okay, I thought that was poison ivy in my house. Put our bed there for now. We're actually gonna sleep in it real quick just to set the spawn point. Click on it, should set the spawn point. Go head down into our temporary hole. And I thought that was a creeper. And we're gonna do the crafting station. As long as you have the crafting station next to a chest, you can see the entire context of the chest, which is real nice. Makes the crafting easier, so we're gonna put the clay there. I'm gonna put a stack of gravel there, and all the same got there to cook, to craft us up some grout, which is needed for the smeltery. Go ahead and grab some coal as well. We're gonna grab it all. We're gonna separate it into three. We're gonna grab some cobblestone. It's probably way more than I needed. And we're gonna go ahead and craft us up three furnaces. There we go. And we're just gonna leave that there. Actually, I need that iron real quick too. A little adventure. While that cooks up, I'll take one more. Cause that's three buckets. We're gonna head back to our home, and we're just gonna place these furnaces right here. We're gonna put coal in there, and oh damn it! And also separate these into stacks of three. You're gonna put a stack in there. A stack in there, and a stack in there, along with some coal. That way it cooks up a little bit faster. Now what I need to make, I don't know if they've changed it. I'm gonna type at Tinkers. Okay, whatever. What do we? We need the smeltery controller, which is made by Seared Bricks. The drain, which is also by Seared Bricks. Seared Bricks by Seared Bricks. And the casting table, the seared faucet. We're gonna also do the seared basin. There's one more thing. And the seared tank. We're gonna actually gonna make three of these right off the bat, so we got need some glass, got some sand here. We're just gonna quickly throw 14 in there to make us up some glass real quick. So we can make those three real quick and go collect some lava for the smelter. Oh, I also have some iron in there, interesting, okay. Okay, put this in here. There we go, okay. Also all the information is in these books as well, so volume one. I think it tells you. It tells you all the recipes for the tool station, the crafting station, and all of that. A bounce pad, interesting. Okay. Also, tells you the recipe for some of the stuff too. It'll give you a new book that goes kind of further in depth. Depth. Let's see. Alright, 14 there. 14 there. 14 there. That should be more than enough to make what I want to real quick. And 8 glass. Awesome. Need to make one of those at my home. I believe it was like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. I only want 3 of the tanks though, and then I'll take the controller. Alright, we'll make whatever else we can out of this real quick, which will be the table, and I believe I can make the faucet as well. Put some of this junk away real quick because it's clogging my inventory and it's really annoying me. Alright, yep. It got us the new book that kind of goes in depth with everything you need. You need one controller, at least one tank, 9 seared bricks, any combination of 10 seared bricks, seared tanks, or drains. Okay, one faucet and one casting table. Alright. I do have to be okay. Let's go ahead and quickly craft us up another crafting station to put right there. That way I don't have to keep going down in that hole. 5 leather, okay. And, what was I gonna say? Oh, right, okay. Now that we got the seared tanks, we're gonna go hunt for some lava. But before we do that, I actually gotta go get a drink real quick, so I'll be right back. Alright, I am back, rehydrated, and make sure I have some food on me. And ready to go hunt for some lava. Look at our mini maps. It looks like there's a little lava area over here. I remember seeing now. Alright, so if we just come over here real quick, place our steer tanks down. Oh, that's right, I have more than one bucket on me, that's why it's annoying. Go ahead and put our lava in these tanks. Each tank holds 4 buckets. I believe that's only 3. Yep, 3. 1, 2, 3, and 4. The cool thing about these is that once you pick them up, it'll retain whatever is inside. So that being the it's dark out. So that being the lava inside is retained and doesn't disappear, so allows for easy transfer. Shut up. So we're just gonna quickly jump over here. Try not to attract these mobs. Come over here and try to sleep before the creeper comes and blows us up. And we're gonna run away. Okay. Just gonna hide over here in the corner real quick. Need to finish this house a little. Oh shit, I really don't want this creeper blown up in my house. Stop creeping on me. Alright. God damn it. Trying not to attract these skeletons. Alright, so what are we missing? We got the controller, we got the faucet, we got the casting table, and Oh fuck, I looked at him. I looked at him. Oh my god, I did not mean to do that. Oh my god, where'd he go? Oh my god, stop making that noise. You're creeping me out. Alright. Where was I? Alright, we still need the drain, I believe. Alright. We're actually going to make two of these. Alright, two drains. We're going to make the casting basin. And then the rest we're going to make into seared bricks. And there we go. Alright, where else? Oh, I gotta repair my gotta repair my shovel real quick so I can do this. Don't you do that. Where's my, oh, I have my tool station, okay. Put that back there, put that in there, put that in, switch it around, repair my shovel. We're about to get some much needed upgrades on our tools. Oh my god, that creeper is in my house. Oh fuck. Oh my god, don't blow up. Don't blow up. Do not blow up my house. Get away from my house. You can blow up over here all you want. I don't care. Just do not blow up near my house. Screw it, we're gonna let you blow up. I'd rather you not blow anything up. Okay, well, it didn't hurt me, so I don't care anymore. Those skeletons are still there. Alright, so to make this meltery, I believe it could be any size now, but it used to have to be a 3x3. So what we're gonna do real quick, we're gonna make a quick 3x3 smeltery just because that's my favorite size to make. We're gonna do that. We're gonna do this. We're gonna have the sear tank right there. We're gonna have the controller right here. We're gonna have another one right there. We're gonna have a drain there. And a drain there, and that oh, damn it. I messed that up. Alright, well, we're gonna pick it all up. I actually need some more grout as well. Alright, so real quick, we're actually gonna move it up. One more. So we're gonna put it right here instead, and then we're gonna do this back, this. Oh, damn it, that's not what I want to do. And some more seared bricks. Damn it. We're gonna have three seared tanks just sitting on top of each other like that. We're gonna have a, where'd that go? A drain right there, drain right there. The controller. Stop doing that right there. I need another faucet as well. Faucet there, and then we're gonna put this in the ground, and then this in the ground, and that will allow us to, what we have to do first is make a casing of, like, a pickaxe head or something, and then that will allow us to pour, like, iron into that casing to make a iron pickaxe head, but, what do I need? Looks like I have sand. I should have some gravel in there. Just need a few more grout. That should be plenty. I think I need more coal in there as well. Clearly did not do enough mining off camera. I'm just gonna take this coal as well. Thank you. I'll clean this up later. We're gonna go back to here. We'll separate like three again. 1, 2, 3. Put you there, you there, you there, you there, you there, you. Ouch! You there. Hide from him real quick too. Okay, he's fancy. Real fancy. Oh god. Damn it, I gotta chop down more of these trees so they die from the sunlight. Hey. Don't mind me. I'll repair my axe real quick. And I'm actually gonna move all this crap to my house because it's getting annoying coming down here. I don't wanna have to come down here anymore. I'll do it off camera. Okay, so let's actually, I think this is the book I need. So what we need to make the casings are, is aluminum brass, which is made from aluminum, 3 aluminum and 1 copper. I do have aluminum and do have copper, 3 aluminum, 1 copper, so 2 copper. That looks like I can only do 1 set. And actually 3 bauxite, which is aluminum. So we can make that real quick, and we're gonna smelt all the iron we have. And I'll just run through this real quick. Shows you how to make the grout, shows you all the stuff for the smeltery. What you can put in there. Oh, is that it? Really? That's it? I thought it showed. It must be another book that shows what I'm talking about. And actually, real quick, let's go ahead and accept this reward for doing the smeltery, which will reward us with 64 coal. Next, building the smeltery, I need 120 grout, which I should have opened that before I did all that, because I'm pretty sure I had it. But that's okay. We're gonna end up smelting a little bit more soon anyway. I wish it detected it. Whatever. I'll finish that off camera. Alright, let's go ahead and make one more faucet real quick. And then the rest of the seared bricks, we need to make this a small smeltery for now, but it'll end up getting bigger as we go on. And I've just finished the multi-block structure, and this should light up. We got our fuel all ready to go. And actually, that ready to go as well. So all we need now is a quick come back down to this stupid hole before I have to end the episode. I do want to at least make a few things. So we're gonna make get a tool rod real quick, and we're also gonna need a pickaxe real quick. Do you count? You don't count, so you're useless to me. You just go there for now. Whatever. And make the pickaxe head real quick. We're not gonna actually make a pickaxe out of those materials. Oh, I should have started smelting that, damn it. But we're gonna run over here real quick. Make sure the mobs don't spawn. Oh, damn it. Whatever. we're going to click on our smelter controller, which will bring up this little GUI, and we're going to put our three bauxite, aka aluminum, and one copper in there real quick. Let that smelt up as I go hide into my little hole to go to sleep, so I can finish this in peace. And actually, did I need a binding as well? I did. So, let's make a binding pattern too. Alright. Right back to our little smelter. Oh my gosh. You gotta be kidding me. And he's got gold armor on. Oh, this is not my day. Oh, and it's enchanted. Go. Go away. Go away. I don't like you. Go away. Damn. And I do not have food on me. Oh my gosh. There is another skeleton over there. I am trying to do stuff. I do not have any food on me. Cook up some stuff real quick as well. Here you go. Here, cook that. Cook this real quick and finally go finish what I'm doing. And actually, I also want to grab some copper as well. There we go. I think three should do. Alright, so that should be finished cooking up right now. Yep, you can see the little liquid in there. Also, the bigger you build your smeltery, the bigger this gooey gets and the more stuff you can put in there. But for now, we're just going to go ahead and put three iron in there and three copper in there. Let that smelt up real quick. So what we're going to do is we're going to get the stone tool rod. We're going to put it on the casting table, and we're going to hit this little faucet to make a cast for the stone, for the tool rod. We can just go ahead and toss that down there, and that will allow us to make a tool rod. You can make the tool rod out of any liquid you want, I believe, as long as it's like copper, iron. I don't think you can do it out of aluminum, brass, or anything like that. So we're just going to let the copper and iron finish cooking up real quick, and I'm actually going to make the rod out of copper. So we're going to go into our little controller, we're going to click the copper. You can click iron to make the iron pour out, but we want the copper to pour out, so we're going to hit the copper, and we're just going to pour it right into the cast. I'm just going to set this aside. We're going to do the same thing for the tool, the binding. Gotta hit aluminum brass first. I combine these buckets too, save a little room in our inventory. There's that, so we can just go ahead and throw this down there as well. We're actually gonna do the binding out of iron. There's a cave under me, so it's pretty annoying. I'll have to go down there and light it up. That'll get us our iron binding, and then we're going to do the same thing for the pickaxe. We're also going to make that out of iron as well. And while that does its thing real quick, we're going to come back to this hole. And I'm going to grab my tool station. Gonna come back over here. We're going to put that right there. That seems like a good spot for it. We're going to go ahead, toss this down the hole as well. And then pick iron. And then let that pour in there. Going to put some more iron in there. And there we go. We have an iron pickaxe head, a copper tool rod, and an iron binding. So I'm going to hit the pickaxe. We're going to put the binding in there. We're going to put the iron pickaxe head in there and the copper tool rod in there. And then we're going to rename this Picky V1. And then there we go. So as you can see, it's definitely a lot better. It has reinforced one, which is good. The durability on this one is 287, where on the stone one, it was 65. So definitely a major improvement. The mining level for the stone one is iron. This one, I can at least do redstone with a mining speed of 6, as where this was a mining speed of 4.61. So definitely a lot better. You can also add modifiers to it, which I will get into on a different episode. But before we end this episode, I'm gonna wish I had a seared brick on me. I believe I should have some iron ingot somewhere. In here? No, that's where my food went. Yep, an ingot. So real quick, we're gonna make an ingot cast. By doing the same thing we just did, hit the aluminum brass, let that pour in there. We're gonna actually keep this ingot, and that will allow us to pour the iron into an ingot form. And actually, once you add ores in there, it will double your ore, so one ore will be 2 ingots, so it'll allow you to get more ingots. Also, this will allow you to get it in a block form if you just want it to drain a little quicker. And I think I actually have all those in my inventory. That's kind of annoying. But we did build a smeltery, but I just have to go back and smelt 120 grout. So I'll do that off camera. I believe we did not do anything else in this. We still have to kill 6 pigs. We did that. Going mining, I still need to get 10 tin ore, which I'm kind of having trouble finding. Next episode, we're going to start working towards this stuff and starting a farm for food that we don't have to keep killing the animals for it. But with this wonderful smeltery made, I think that will do it for this episode. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions or tips or anything like that, then feel free to let me know in the comments below. Also, give it a thumbs up if you liked it, a thumbs down if you didn't like it. I understand some people may not like it, and that's fine. Just let me know what I can change, and I'll do my best to change it for you. But until next time, thanks for watching. Goodbye.